bigger people, as we tend to have to do. You may know of some of them. You may have heard of Just Taxi. We helped them bring down their CPA by 90%. Other people have used it. They went against Uber. Not a good call. sorry, just not a good call. You may not have heard of Go Augmented. They're a little spin out from a university. We did augmented reality back in the day. We started working with people like Adidas, Samsung, Man City. Did pretty well for itself. I did the business development, we did okay. I usually work in this area, of course, mobile and high tech. I've been in it for years. Bit of a granddaddy, has to be said. I was there when it was rubbish. And mobile for a long time has been a bit rubbish. My mum said about wearables, same with mobile. It was the year of in 2010. Every year it was the year. I've been a brand evangelist for the mobile industry, for people like Blipper, augmented reality, surely the largest one now in the world, perhaps. But anyway, that's what I've been. So the big thing for me is I've been there, seen it, and done it. And the big thing for me is we've got to beware. You've got to beware of the hype cycle. This is the biggest problem we've got, okay? Because the hype cycle is a naughty thing. It is a naughty thing, and it gets us every single time. The hype cycle says we've got this wonderful peak of inflated expectations, and that's exactly where we are at the moment, okay? Everyone's very, very excited by it. It's going to be the brave new world. This is exactly where we are right now. The problem being is this, and everyone knows that you guys are very bright here, so you know, you've got this wonderful chasm problem. You've got the crossing of the chasm. So you've gone from, you know, this wonderful, everyone gets very excited, trough of disillusionment, into the chasm. We're nowhere near early adopters. We're nowhere near it. Loads of things are going to fail at this moment, and I think that's where wearables is going to go as well. It's going to go into that chasm and then come out. The reason why I know we're at the peak is because people are saying things like this. They're saying things like, the user, 70 billion. It's going to be 50 billion according to Crisis. According to these guys, it's going to be 8.6 billion. According to someone else, it's going to be trillions of these devices. This is what everyone says at that moment of peak inflation with the expectations. We all do. It hasn't exactly where they are. I know it's going to happen with wearables. With AR, it was going to be this. Just like all reality, except only more so. Dun, dun, dun. AR is going to be amazing. Yeah, right, okay. In reality, how many people really are wearing them, really doing the augmented reality stuff? In reality. Google's coming over now. Ish. So it's kind of grumpy face. That's reality. Reality is grumpy face. Except, happy things. Where be next for wearables? I did the wear thing again. I was going to make the baby a pirate, but I thought that'd be too far. So, where be next for wearables? Okay. Mobile has usual suspects, okay, and it's always wasted. If you look to the past, we'll see the future. So fashion, absolutely right. Retail, yes. Automotive, high-end B2C. That's kind of traditionally where mobile's done very well. It's all about creating these moments, okay, these little moments of marketing joy. This is where we're going to be heading. And if wearables doesn't do this, it won't actually exist, really, isn't it? So every minute marketing, that's where we are right now. Moments of joy, interactions, instant interactions, and linking into marketing. So we started off with hardware, of course. Mike rightly said about the Fitbit, loads are going to be coming over, absolutely right, and as he said himself, fantastic, that's where I think they're going to be in a couple of months' time. Yeah, they're going to be in soft draws, all lost. Okay, this is the reality. Because really, it's about me. Maybe it's just me, maybe I'm just getting a bit fun, but I don't really run around enough. But the people who are obsessed with themselves, fitness freaks, perfect market for mobile, obsessed with tech, obsessed with themselves, with being mobile. That's what they are. Yeah, they are. That's why they're the perfect people for it. But this is the problem. This is the problem. So you're going to have things like this. One of the things are people's socks they can now put on. Fantastic. One of my favourite wearables is this with the heart thing. Heart rate. This is the Japanese version. It's a lot more naughty than this way. They go, yes, it is. Just weird, though. Yeah. We won't talk about that at the time. You usually talk about these two, which are the cancer thing, which I think is wonderfully obsessed. But people who are obsessed themselves take loads of pictures. Great. It's not going to take off for most of the people. Olive is another lovely one based on stress. And has anyone heard of Pavlov? Has anyone come out with Pavlov? And it literally zaps you. Yeah? It zaps you when you're doing something naughty, you're rough. It zaps you. So we're going to be paying for stuff with PayPal and watches, looking cool, that's great. Or we're going to be playing on our mobile phones with these fantastic games. By the way, that timeliness already exists anyway in the games market, so you don't need that. Or you can do this one, which is what I think is brilliant. Start your car, I don't know if it's this yet, start your car like Knight Rider. Great. Doesn't that exist already? And Uber, you're missing a trick if that's the case. No, it just is. Okay. So there's one. Big opportunity for me actually, isn't it? B2C, it's in B2B. I'm never going to take off, never mind. But business to business. Okay, going to Salesforce is where the big growth is going to come. You can get more productivity out of your team if they wear these wearable devices. Really, really weird to that, this one. Approximately a third of people they studied, that's probably three people, but anyway, said that it helped their career.
Remember early for that one, but there
we go. There's a problem, of course. Future gazing, if you step. The map is not the territory. That's the reality. The map is not the territory. It may not be the same. There are some key problems with it, and Martin's actually done a couple of these arrays, he's absolutely right. Battery life, big one, massive problem. Could overcome it with solar and other stuff, maybe. Signs, massive problem. Of course, with Moore's Law and all this kind of stuff, we will overcome it. But two more, in fact, four more. Two are quite jokey and the other ones are quite serious. Bluetooth conundrum and a dog factor. Number one, Bluetooth conundrum is this. Okay. Even Brad Pitt can't make it look cool. That's a worry. That's a worry. Okay. And the high dog factor, of course. Because this was only a few years ago. Okay? That's the reality. And I know I'm a massive geek, I'm a massive dog, but it's the way it is. The other one, and this is a serious one if you're a developer or if you're working as well, the real bummer is this, is the fact that it doesn't really add that much value. It don't add that much value. That's why Peter Thiel here rightly says, doesn't see any point, doesn't see that much. The biggest one I want to talk about then with is about data. And data is the massive opportunity here. It's a huge opportunity. But the problem with it being a huge opportunity is who really becomes empowered? Who really opens that data? That's going to be the thing. It's great that we can do all this stuff with health, etc. True, but what about insurance, etc.? So even including kind of, because I know you're very long, a fad is something that comes along, fashionable for a short period of time, and goes without trace. Okay? That's what it's saying. A better way, I think, of saying that is this one. Much nicer way of putting it is, a wave is a fad, and a tide is the trend. It's a much nicer way of putting it. And in reality, we're in this first wave of wearables. We're in the first wave, but I actually don't believe in any way that this is the way the tide's going. It's not the way at all. Because of this thing here. Mobile phones, they will win out. They're absolutely right, they're going to win out. Because they're almost a wearable anyway, for crying out loud. We don't allow it. I'm panicking now because my phone's over there. And someone, you know, literally, yeah. So I think that's a thing. I don't know what you guys think of that. See, it's 3 meters away from me, I'm already panicking up here, so don't try to steal it. So I'm going to pass over to Nine now, thanks for your time.